just failed for our vain help.
Sister Leona, your eyes are failing you for vain help. That's the emotion that you're feeling. That's why the tears are running. Because everywhere that you have turned up until today, it's been nothing but failure, correct? Everything that you have tried. You said you got on the alcohol. You said earlier that that was not the answer. You know that. But you continue doing it simply because it takes you into a temporary feel-good position. What we're talking about today, it helps you to deal with that, but that's only a temporary solution, sis. That's temporary because guess what? When the effects of that alcohol wear off, you're still in the same predicament that you were in. You have not found a true solution.
That's what I'm looking for help.
You found it today. You see that flyer that you got? That flyer is the beginning steps of you finding that solution, sir. Okay? Same with your brother. You brothers got a flyer? Y'all make sure y'all look at those flyers because guess what? That is the answer to the problems that you have that you are seeking.
Well, I see y'all recording, so I hear what you're saying. I receive everything you're saying.
Okay.
But everybody is not on the same level.
Exactly.
So, like, if I seen you without that purple on, I wouldn't know that you were spiritual. I wouldn't know if you was an Israelite, I wouldn't know that just with regular clothes, right?
Okay.
So I feel like you have a message that you're reaching out for. You have a certain amount, a certain type of person that you're reaching out for.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not everybody. Cause like if I wouldn't spoke to you, you wouldn't know that I come from a religious family. I already know Israelites, they speaking about us. I know that Bible like the back of my hand, but that didn't change my life. What changes your life is accepting God, and the Bible not gonna, it's like this.
Give me Ezekiel 3:17. Go ahead, Paul. Keep on talking.
Limit the Bible, they limit God to the Bible.
Okay.
Now, we all know the history behind the Bible. We know how it came of existence, right? We know who gave it to us, the same oppressor, right? So I'm not against the Bible. But what I am saying is, if we have a spiritual connection with God, there's no way all that power, that the only way I'm gonna get direction is from reading the scripture by man, and I know he put that in my DNA. If I just reach out to him, that
boy don't come to me. So let me ask you, how long have you been on the face of the earth?
35 years.
35 years.
One last thing, I'm sorry to interrupt, but
I have to
go.
Okay, sister
Leona. Hey, it's the end.
Officer Bernard, can you get her information? She's getting ready to go. Sister, we wanna deal with you. Okay. No problem, sis. Understood. I want you to take that flyer and introduce it to your husband as well. Because we want him here as well.
I don't care. If I have to go first, he could leave out my life.
You can talk that. Sis, nobody said that you have to divorce and separate. Listen. Listen. Take that flyer, give it to him when you get home, and let him know you found a place that is willing to help both of y'all. Okay, well then guess what? Then you become the example. Then you become the example and start keeping God's law, okay?
You can't do it.
All right, all praise to
you.
All right. Brother Willie, 35 years in the truth, okay? So you're telling me that God put his instructions into your DNA.
And he had to. Every creation.
He had to?
Every creation he ever made did not have a book.
Give me Numbers 15, verse 38.
It's already in your DNA.
It's already in your DNA.
I feel like that's
okay. So now let me ask you. If the Bible is already in your DNA.
Not the Bible. God's instructions for my life and God's plan.
That's the Bible.
No, sir.
That's the Bible.
So you telling me if you knew someone was a despicable person and they have a restaurant, you know they're despicable, tribal people, you're gonna go in there and eat that. You're not.
Okay.
You're gonna go somewhere else.
So now I'm gonna answer the question again.
Right.
35 years on the face of the world, you're telling me that the Most High instilled his word into your DNA.
Yes, sir.
So here's the question to you. If the Most High instilled his word, his laws, his instructions to you into your DNA, why aren't you doing them?
Right. I'm not.
How do I know you're not? Because I can look at you and
that's
tell
right.
that you are not
there.
Let
right.
me show you. Let me show you. Let me show you. Okay? This is why I say you have to follow what the Bible says. Listen. Read that.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 15, verse 38. Speak unto the children of Israel.
So notice the Most High God says, speak unto the children of Israel, which is who? The Israelites, right? You already said you know who the Israelites are. So you know that you're an Israelite.
But But once you say you...
Wait a minute, you know you're an Israelite, right?
That I'm living wrong.
I'm finna show you.
You got spiritual connection, though.
That means we took the time to read the instructions that God left for us.
You're not about to read the Bible. Right. To come and look at a person and say...
Read it again.
Bring it up.
Start from the top. Listen, Brother Willie. Listen to what God says in his instructions.
Speak unto the children of Israel and bid them that they make them branches in the borders of their garments.
So do you hear that? The Most High God said you are to put fringes in the borders of your garments. Okay. Read.
Throughout their generations.
Every generation that comes forth needs to be wearing fringes on the bottom of their garments according to thus said the Lord.
Right.
Not according to you. You said the Most High put his instructions into your DNA.
Right.
Here's the first question, Brother Willie. Where are your fringes?
I can answer that by saying, how can I go off the Old Testament when you go into Bible now? That's why they made a whole
new Testament.
They brought a whole New Testament and a new covenant, and you don't have to do the old
okay.
way.
Okay. Right.
But that's a question I always have.
All right, so now, bro. No, hold on. I'm going to address that.
Right.
I'm going to address that. But now, listen. Again, I want you to get your will thinking. Because you said he put his instructions into your DNA.
Right.
Well, here's one that you missed. Because this is not in your DNA. This is in the Bible and God's law.
That's
it
right.
says you are to wear fringes on the borders of your garment every generation.
Right.
Meaning what? You are supposed to have fringes on. If God's instructions were into your DNA, you would have fringes on right now.
That's right.
Do you understand?
No.
You don't understand. In other words, let me show you. In other words, there is more to the Bible than just a feeling.
Right, I understand.
Okay. Now, hold on. Don't go nowhere because I'm going to deal with your exact second question that you said about the Old Testament and the New Testament. Because you said, how can we go into the Old Testament and deal with the Old Testament when there's a whole New Testament? So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the New Testament, and I'm going to get it from Christ's own mouth concerning the Old Testament. Give me Matthew chapter 5, verse 17.
Bring it up!
Right? So, Brother Willie, listen to what Christ said concerning what was written in the Old Testament. All right? Listen.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 17.
Well, because you've been reading it, Brother Willie, we're going to read this scripture, and I need you to give me the understanding on it. Read.
Think not that I have come to destroy the law or the prophets.
So notice, Christ said, don't think that I come to destroy the law or the prophets. This is Christ speaking. All right? Read it from the top again.
Think not that I have come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not, as you will, I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law.
Brother Willie, what does that mean?
I don't know.
Wait a minute. You just said you had God's laws into your DNA.
I'm going to get direction if I'm reading a scripture by man, and I know he put that in my DNA. I'm going to get direction if I'm reading a scripture by man, and I know he put that in my DNA. If I'm going to get direction if I'm reading a scripture by man, and I know he put that in my DNA.
Said we supposed to go into the New Testament to get our understanding from the old. Well, here we are in the New Testament. Christ is speaking. And he's telling you something about the Old Testament.
Because I'm really not trying to answer that question because I'm not here to.
Well, guess what? If you're not, it's not about debate.
Right.
You said that you have God's laws
y'all
in your DNA.
To get understanding, right? So
yes.
I have questions.
So here's the question. Here's the question. Are you really over here to understand? Because
the book of Ezekiel, chapter 3, verse 17.
Bring it up.
Oh, what's up?
Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
So when God says son of man, he's talking to you. You might as well put Brother Willie where it says son of man. He said, I have made you a watchman over the house of Israel, over your brothers and sisters that have not repented. Read.
But I made you a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth.
Hear the word at God's mouth. God's mouth is this Bible.
Right.
Everything that he required of you, every instruction that he told you to give, he didn't put it into your DNA. That's Christianity. Christianity tells you they're going to write it into your heart and you're just going to know it and it's a feeling. No. God says you got to go in and read my word.
Right.
Hear the word at God's mouth.
And hear the word at my mouth and give the warning from me.
And give the people the understanding of what it is that they're doing wrong. That's what he's telling you right here. Now, go back to Matthew 5:17. I'm going to break this down so that you understand what Christ is talking about concerning Old Testament and New Testament. Then we're going to get into the history where you said the Bible is not our book. The Bible is our book. And it is only for us. The problem is the other nations have taken the book and changed things around so that you are misunderstood. When you go in and try to get the understanding, you lean on another nation. We don't lean on another nation to give us the understanding. The Most High has given us our own teachers that have the proper understanding on how to read the Bible.
That's right.
You understand?
Okay.
All right. Hold on, brother. We're going to walk through it. We're going to walk through it. Give me Matthew 5:17. I'm going to break this one down for you again.
This is the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 17. Think not that I have come to destroy the law.
So listen, when Christ was on the face of the earth, was the New Testament written? No. So what was Christ quoting when he would quote scriptures? Old Testament. So Christ is telling you here in the scriptures, he says, don't think that I come to do away with the law. Where is the law found? The books of Moses, when we were given the law, the Ten Commandments.
That's right. Well, can't we find
Listen.
100 of them.
That's all. You're going a little deep, but we can answer that.
That's why I was trying
to answer that. We can answer that. We're going to answer this. Just bear with it, because I'm breaking it down into stages so you get proper understanding.
But see, it's not that, okay. I'm not going to receive it because I'm not debating with the Israelites.
Well, this is not about a debate. This is giving you the proper instructions and understanding of who you are in this last stage.
I understand. Okay. Them instructions good, but we still at the bottom of the totem pole. We can pray. We can do prayer.
All right, all right. So now, Brother Willie, since we are at the bottom of the totem pole, here's what I need from you.
We need warriors.
Oh, you're a warrior.
Yes,
so what are you ready to do?
I'm ready to die whatever for the cause. I went far for the white folk as a Marine.
Give me 2 Corinthians 10:4.
Whoever they said go die for, why not die for my people?
All right, Marine Corps. Simplify.
Yes, sir. Everybody else, they fought.
Did you hear what I said?
Simplify. Hoorah, but everybody
okay,
else
so
fought.
Guess what? So guess what? Is that our warfare?
It's our warfare for our people.
It's the warfare for our people?
For our people.
Let me show you something. New Testament. Like you like to quote. New Testament.
Fight,
read.
This is the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 10 and verse 4. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
Did you hear what God said? The weapons of our warfare is not carnal. What you fail to realize, I'm glad that you said you were in the Marine Corps so you can help understand. You're in a firefight, but the firefight that you're in is not a physical fight with physical machine guns and 5.56 millimeters.
That's right.
Okay. The fight that you are in is a spiritual fight for your mindset. The fight that we are losing, the fight that you can't find solutions to, is because you're looking in the wrong place. Watch this. You're ready to fight and die to uplift the black man, right? So you're ready to go get machine guns and ammunition to go take it to your enemy, right? Who makes the machine guns?
Bring it out.
Who makes the bullets?
The enemy.
Bring it out.
So when the machine gun breaks or jams, or you run out of ammunition, who are you going to turn to get your weaponry up?
Us.
You want to turn to us? Okay. Show me a black-owned armory. Show me a black-owned ammunition store somewhere around here where you can go arm up all of your people and take the war to your enemy. Show it to me. Where is it?
They don't have it.
So the scripture says the weapons of your warfare are not carnal.
That's right.
You are not to be picking up guns. You are not to be picking up bullets to try to take it to your enemy. That is the blessing of your enemy to wage war against all the people of the face of the earth.
That's right.
And you fall off the mark because you are leaning on your own understanding, trying to follow what the other nations do versus what God tells you to do in the scriptures.
That's right.
That's where you fall off, brother. The weapons of our warfare are not corner. You are not to pick up a machine gun. You are not to pick up a knife. You are not to go physical with your enemy because you will lose. You know for a fact that Esau has the number one military on the face of the earth. You was a part of it, just like I was a part of it. And you understand his capability of being able to go in there and destroy nations with the drop of a flick. You understand that. So why would you turn around, understanding the power that he has, and try to come at him carnally, physically?
Right.
You can't.
I'd rather die on my feet than lay on my back.
So dying on your feet, in order to die on your feet and be successful at what it is you're trying to do, brother Willie, you need to change your understanding of how to fight.
Right.
That's just one way of fighting. But that is few and far beyond what God told you to do in the scriptures. Understand this, the Most High controls the spirit and the flesh. You want to go fight and you just want to fight on the physical side. What about the spiritual? Because Esau has tricked you and deceived you and been fighting you since the day that you were born. You have been deceived from the time you came out of your mother's womb all the way up until today. It's been nothing but a spiritual war going on with you.
That's right.
And that is why you don't have solutions to what you have today, because you cannot recognize that Esau, dude, wait a minute, is Esau out here putting a gun to your head right now? But you are at war with them. Why? Because you see them killing us in the streets every day, right? You are at war with them, but nobody has a gun to your head right here. Has the KKK came on this block any week and marched up and down and destroyed your house? No, but you're at war with them. So what type of war are we dealing with? It's not a physical war, it is a spiritual war.
That's right.
The war is for your salvation.
That's right.
This is what God's message is to you in the scriptures.
Bring it out.
You understand? Esau taught you how to fight physically. And then you go out and you see your people being shot down in the street and it makes you mad. You get upset. Give me Ecclesiastes 7:7. You get mad, you get upset, you want to do something about it. You want to retaliate because you are tired of the oppression and you're waiting for something to happen.
Right.
The thing is, as long as you keep thinking carnally, as long as you keep looking toward the street, looking at the ways that Esau taught you how to fight, you're not going to win. It's a fixed fight.
Right.
Esau set up this whole system for you to never win.
Right.
That's right.
Never win.
That's right.
No matter what you do.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.